Hello students, in the previous lecture of jurisprudence we had started modern theories in relation to the concept of natural law. In the previous lecture we had discussed how the concept of natural law had been rejected by the jurist in the 19th century and how in the 20th century there was again a revival to the concept of natural law. During the 20th century many jurists and philosophers given their theories in relation to the concept of natural law, and out of those philosophers Stemmler and J. Kohler hold very good important place. Rudolf Stemmler was born in the year 1856 and he had been died in the year 1938. He was a German professor of law and he is regarded as father of contemporary natural law. According to him, law binds an individual externally, whereas ethics of an individual binds him to obey the law by his internal desires. He accepted the notion that law is a regulation of external conduct, while ethics as having to do with the intention of the actor. According to him, law should be sovereign. Law should be sovereign means to say law should be above than all the individuals, and it should be without any type of interference, and it should be inviolable. Inviolable means it should never be broken by any individual. I want to repeat, according to him, law should be sovereign without interference and it should be inviolable. That means to say never to be broken. According to him, a theory of law must consider every specific legal rule as a means to an end. According to him, every specific legal rule in the theory of law is given to achieve an objective. And for this purpose, he said that there is need to look or find a universal method of just law. What is the meaning of just law? The law which is acceptable to every individual in the society. Because according to him, once law is made or enacted, then law is compulsory and it is binding to all, whether they intend to follow the law or they do not intend to follow the law, the law will be binding. According to Stemmler, the aim of justice is to create harmony in the society. And that harmony can be achieved by adjusting the desire of the individual with the aim of the community. He said that in realization of justice, the specific content of a rule of law will vary from place to place and from age to age. According to him, a rule of law may be hold good in one place, but that rule of law may not hold good in another place. It may happen that over a one period of time, a particular rule of law will hold to be very good, but that particular rule of law may not hold good in another part of the period. So he said that a specific content of rule of law will vary from place to place and from age to age. So there is need to change the law from place to place and from period to period. He said that the aim of just law is to achieve the highest possible harmony in the society. He said that there must be free will of men to obey the law in order to build a harmonious society. So how a harmonious society can be built according to Stemmler? It can be built only when each and every individual wants to obey the law. Obedience to law should not depend on the arbitrariness of another. That means, don't harass the people to obey the law. If you want to make your law to run in the society, then ensure that the dignity of any person should be maintained. When you enact the law, then don't segregate people. Don't degrade anybody in the society if you want to run the law. Stemmler says, each and every positive law is an attempt to make a just law. What he says, all positive law is an attempt at just law. What is the meaning of just law? Just law means justice law in which there is harmony of will or purpose of the individuals within the framework of the social life. And this harmony of will or purpose varies according to time and place. For the knowledge of will and purpose, he said that if you want to know what is the will or purpose of the individual in relation to any particular law, then you must come in actual contact with the living social world. If you come in the actual contact with the living social world, then by this method, we can find out what is relatively just and what is relatively not just. And it is this justice which the law should endeavor to attain. He said that law is valid even if it does not conform to this just, but every effort, but every attempt should be made to bring the positive law near to the just law. This concept has been called by Stemmler as natural law with a variable content. So this is something about the theory which was propounded by Stemmler. If I want to conclude the theory of Stemmler, then I will conclude that every positive law should try to harmonize the will of the individual within the social framework. Do not compel any person to obey the law. Law should be made according to the will of the individuals. If the law is made according to the will of the individuals, then there will be the internal spirit of every individual to obey the law. So this was something about the natural law theory given by Stemmler. Now let us discuss the theory of natural law given by J. Collar. J. Collar was born in the year 1849 and died in the year 1919. J. Collar gave a new interpretation to the legal history. According to him, legal interpretation should not be materialistic, should not be money oriented. J. Collar said that when there was development of the society, and in this course of evolution, society advances morally and culturally as well. He argued that taking the requirement of cultural into consideration, law can serve its purpose better. Means to say, while making the law, if you take into consideration the requirement of culture of the society, then the law which will be made by you can serve the purpose better. According to Collar, there is no eternal law, as was suggested by the previous jurist. He said that law that is suitable for one period is not so for another period. He said that we can only evaluate every culture with its corresponding system of law. He built his theory on the idea that law is a process of evolution, and this law must change with the time, because a law which is valid for one period may not hold good for another period. So law must change with the time, and it must vary with the culture of the countries. A single law cannot be applied universally to each and every culture of the countries. The law must vary with the cultures of the countries, according to J. Collar. So this is something about the concept of natural law by J. Collar. If you like my channel, then please subscribe my channel. And if you want to get notes of my law lectures, then you can go to Google and type lawarticles2020.blogspot.com, where you will find the notes of my law lectures. So thank you very much.